Section 40 of The Art of Cookery Made Plain and Easy by Hannah Glasse. This LibriVox recording is in the public domain. Editions. First printed in the 5th edition and now enlarged and improved. To dress a turtle the West India way. Take the turtle out of water the night before you dress it, and lay it on its back. In the morning, cut its head off, and hang it up by its hind fins for it to bleed till the blood is all out. Then cut the callipy, which is the belly, round, and raise it up. Cut as much meat to it as you can. Throw it into spring water with a little salt. Cut the fins off, and scald them with the head. Take off all the scales, cut all the white meat out, and throw it into spring water and salt. The guts and lungs must be cut out. Wash the lungs very clean from the blood. Then take the guts and more, and slit them open, wash them very clean, and put them on to boil in a large pot of water, and boil them till they are tender. Then take off the inside skin, and cut them in pieces of 2 or 3 inches long. Have ready a good veal broth made as follows. Take 1 large or 2 small knuckles of veal, and put them on in 3 gallons of water. Let it boil, skim it well, season with turnips, onions, carrots, and celery, and a good large bundle of sweet herbs. Boil it till it is half wasted, then strain it off. Take the fins and put them in a stew pan. Cover them with veal broth. Season with an onion chopped fine, all sorts of sweet herbs chopped very fine, 1/2 ounce of cloves and mace, 1/2 nutmeg beat very fine. Stew it very gently till tender. Then take the fins out and put in 1 pint of Madeira wine and stew it for 15 minutes. Beat up the whites of 6 eggs with the juice of 2 lemons. Put the liquor in and boil it up. Run it through a flannel bag. Make it hot, wash the fins very clean, and put them in. Take a piece of butter and put at the bottom of a stew pan. Put your white meat in and sweat it gently till it is almost tender. Take the lungs and heart and cover them with veal broth, with an onion, herbs, and spice. As for the fins, stew them till tender. Take out the lungs, strain the liquor off, thicken it, and put in a bottle of Madeira wine. Season with cayenne pepper and salt pretty high. Put in the lungs and white meat. Stew them up gently for 15 minutes. Have some forcemeat balls made out of the white part instead of veal, as for Scotch collops. If any eggs, scald them. If not, take 12 hard yolks of eggs made into egg balls. Have your calipash, or deep shell, done round the edges with paste. Season it in the inside with cayenne pepper and salt, and a little Madeira wine. Bake it 1/2 hour, then put in the lungs and white meat, forcemeat, and eggs over, and bake it 1/2 hour. Take the bones and 3 quarts of veal broth, seasoned with an onion, a bundle of sweet herbs, 2 blades of mace, stew it 1 hour, strain it through a sieve, thicken it with flour and butter, put in 1/2 pint of Madeira wine, stew it 1/2 hour. Season with cayenne pepper and salt to your liking. This is the soup. Take the callipy, run your knife between the meat and shell, and fill it full of forcemeat. Season it all over with sweet herbs chopped fine, a shallot chopped, cayenne pepper and salt, and a little Madeira wine. Put a paste round the edge, and bake it 1 hour and a half. Take the guts and more, put them in a stew pan with a little broth, a bundle of sweet herbs, 2 blades of mace beat fine. Thicken with a little butter rolled in flour. Stew them gently for 1/2 hour. Season with cayenne pepper and salt. Beat up the yolks of 2 eggs in 1/2 pint of cream. Put it in and keep stirring it 1 way till it boils up. then dish them up as follows. First, the callipee, then the fricassee, soup and fins, followed by the callipash. The fins eat fine when cold, put by in the liquor. Another way to dress a turtle. Kill your turtle as before, then cut the belly shell clean off, cut off the fins, take all the white meat out, and put it into spring water. Take the guts and lungs out. Do the guts as before. Wash the lungs well. Scald the fins, head, and belly shell. Take a saw and saw the shell all round about 2 inches deep. Scald it and take the shell off, cut it in pieces. Take the shells, fins, and head and put them in a pot, cover them with veal broth. Season with 2 large onions chopped fine, all sorts of sweet herbs chopped fine, 1/2 ounce of cloves and mace, a whole nutmeg. Stew them till tender. Take out all the meat and strain the liquor through a sieve. Cut the fins in 2 or 3 pieces. Take all the brawn from the bones. Cut it in pieces of about 2 inches square. Take the white meat, put some butter at the bottom of a stew pan, put your meat in, and sweat it gently over a slow fire till almost done. Take it out of the liquor and cut it in pieces about the bigness of a goose's egg. Take the lungs and heart and cover them with veal broth. Season with an onion, sweet herbs, and a little beet spice. Always observe to boil the liver by itself. Stew it till tender, take the lungs out and cut them in pieces. Strain off the liquor through a sieve. Take a pound of butter and put in a large stew pan, big enough to hold all the turtle, and melt it. Put 1/2 pound of flour in and stir it till it is smooth. Put in the liquor and keep stirring it till it is well mixed. If lumpy, strain it through a sieve. Put in your meat of all sorts, a great many forcemeat balls and egg balls, and put in 3 pints of Madeira wine. Season with pepper and salt and cayenne pepper pretty high. Stew it 3/4 of an hour. Add the juice of 2 lemons. Have your deep shell baked. Put some into the shells and bake it or brown it with a hot iron, and serve the rest in tureens. Note well, this is for a turtle of 60 pounds weight. To make a mock turtle. Take a large calf's head with the skin on, well scalded and cleaned. Boil it 3/4 of an hour. Take it out and slit it down the face. Take all the skin and meat from the bones as clean as possible. Be careful you do not break off the ears. Lay it on a dresser and fill the ears full of forcemeat. Tie them round with a cloth. Take out the eyes and pick all the meat from the bones. Put it in a large stew pan with the best and fattest parts of another head without the skin, boiled as long as the above, and 3 quarts of veal gravy. Lay the skin on the meat with the flesh side up, and cover the pan close. Let it stew 1 hour over a moderate fire. Put in 3 sweetbreads cut in pieces, 2 ounces of truffles and morels, 4 artichoke bottoms boiled and cut in 4 pieces each, an anchovy boned and chopped small, season it pretty high with salt and cayenne pepper, put in 1/2 lemon, 3 pints of Madeira wine, 2 spoonfuls of ketchup, 1 of lemon pickle, 1/2 pint of pickled or fresh mushrooms, 1/4 pound of butter rolled in flour, and let it all stew 1/2 hour longer. Take the yolks of 4 eggs boiled hard, and the brains of both heads boiled. Cut the brains in pieces of the size of a nutmeg, make a rich forcemeat, and roll it up in a veal caul, and then in a cloth, and boil it 1 hour. Cut it in 3 parts, the middle piece the largest. Put the meat into the dish, and lay the head over it, the skin side uppermost. Put the largest piece of forcemeat between the ears, the other two slices at the narrow end opposite each other. Put the brains, eggs, mushrooms, etc. over and round it, and pour the liquor hot upon it, and send it up as quick as possible, as it soon gets cold. To make ice cream. Pare and stone 12 ripe apricots and scald them. Beat them fine in a mortar. Add to them 6 ounces of double refined sugar and a pint of scalding cream, and work it through a sieve. Put it in a tin with a close cover, and set it in a tub of ice broken small, with 4 handfuls of salt mixed among the ice. When you see your cream grows thick round the edges of your tin, stir it well, and put it in again till it is quite thick. When the cream is all froze up, take it out of the tin, and put it into the mould you intend to turn it out of. Put on the lid and have another tub of salt and ice ready as before. Put the mould in the middle and lay the ice under and over it. Let it stand 4 hours and never turn it out till the moment you want it. Then dip the mould in cold spring water and turn it into a plate. You may do any sort of fruit the same way. A turkey, etc., in jelly. Boil a turkey or a fowl as white as you can, let it stand till cold, and have ready a jelly made thus. Take a fowl, skin it, take off all the fat, do not cut it to pieces, nor break the bones. Take 4 pounds of a leg of veal, without any fat or skin. Put it into a well-tin saucepan, put to it full 3 quarts of water. Set it on a very clear fire till it begins to simmer. Be sure to skim it well, but take great care it does not boil. When it is well skimmed, set it so as it will but just seem to simmer. Put to it 2 large blades of mace, 1/2 nutmeg, and 20 corns of white pepper, a little bit of lemon peel as big as a sixpence. This will take 6 or 7 hours doing. When you think it is a stiff jelly, which you will know by taking a little out to cool, be sure to skim off all the fat, if any, and be sure not to stir the meat in the saucepan. A 1/4 hour before it is done, throw in a large teaspoonful of salt, squeeze in the juice of 1/2 fine Seville orange or lemon. When you think it is enough, strain it off through a clean sieve, but do not pour it off quite to the bottom, for fear of settlings. Lay the turkey or fowl in the dish you intend to send it to the table in. Beat up the whites of 6 eggs to a froth, and put the liquor to it, then boil it 5 or 6 minutes, and run it through a jelly bag till it is very clear. Then pour the liquor over it, let it stand till quite cold. Colour some of the jelly in different colours, and when it is near cold, with a spoon, sprinkle it over in what form or fancy you please, and send it to table. A few nasturtium flowers, stuck here and there, look pretty, if you can get them, but lemon and all those things are entirely fancy. This is a very pretty dish for a cold collation or a supper. All sorts of birds or fowls may be done this way. To make citron. Quarter your melon and take out all the inside, then put into the syrup as much as will cover the coat. Let it boil in the syrup till the coat is as tender as the inward part, then put them in the pot with as much syrup as will cover them. Let them stand for 2 or 3 days, that the syrup may penetrate through them, and boil your syrup to a candy height, with as much mountain wine as will wet your syrup. Clarify it, and then boil it to a candy height. Then dip in the quarters, and lay them on a sieve to dry, and set them before a slow fire, or put them in a slow oven till dry. Observe that your melon is but half ripe, and when they are dry, put them in deal boxes in paper. To candy cherries or greengages. Dip the stalks and leaves in white wine vinegar boiling, then scald them in syrup. Take them out and boil the syrup to a candy height. Dip in the cherries and hang them to dry with the cherries downwards. Dry them before the fire or in the sun. Then take the plums. After boiling them in a thin syrup, peel off the skin and candy them, and so hang them up to dry. To take iron moulds out of linen. Take sorrel, bruise it well in a mortar, squeeze it through a cloth, bottle it, and keep it for use. Take a little of the above juice in a silver or tin saucepan. Boil it over a lamp. As it boils, dip in the iron mould. Do not rub it, but only squeeze it. As soon as the iron mould is out, throw it into cold water. To make India pickle. To a gallon of vinegar, 1 pound of garlic, 3/4 of a pound of long pepper, 1 pint of mustard seed, 1 pound of ginger, and 2 ounces of turmeric. The garlic must be laid in salt 3 days, then wiped clean and dried in the sun. The long pepper broke and the mustard seed bruised. Mix all together in the vinegar. Then take 2 large hard cabbages and 2 cauliflowers, cut them in quarters and salt them well. Let them lie 3 days and dry them well in the sun. Note well, the ginger must lie 24 hours in salt and water, then cut small and laid in salt 3 days. To prevent the infection among horned cattle. Make an issue in the dewlap, put in a peg of black hellebore and rub all events both behind and before with tar. End of section 40.